Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen. Alumni, young children, older people, current students, welcome to Homecoming 2011's WLA Skit Night. Ladies and gentlemen, I've got a feeling that tonight's going to be a good night. Now please give a round of applause for your MCs for the evening. First, she was raised by a herd of wild llamas in eastern Indiana since the age of 3. Please welcome Kelsey Pizza! Next, he's a man who until 2006 held the Wisconsin 4-H record for most continuous cows milked in a 24-hour period. Please welcome Scotty Bates!
Let's kick it off. I know the
will of the ball. Get down, go. And finally, your third MC, Mike Rosenfeld. Take that noodle off and drop it, fill up my cup. Mazel tov. Look at her dancing. Just take it off. Let's paint the town. We'll shut it down. Stop the music. Stop the music. I warned you three. If I was going to help, there was going to be no dancing. I was preaching for morning chapel at Grace Oshkosh today. A third grader came up to me and said, "Hey, Pastor Bieber, how you doing?" That's not going to happen this year. There is going to be no dancing at this skit night. And to be honest, it's sort of a shame because I do have rhythm. You tricked me. You tricked me. 1 year ago, I went home from this skit night and my wife refused to let me in the house. My kids wouldn't let me call them dad for a month. There's gonna be no dancing. Which, to be honest, is sort of sad because I do have rhythm. I've been a pastor for 15 years, and this might be the last 20 minutes of me in the ministry. But doggone it, we are not going to dance. Which is sad because I got rhythm. Taste me how to do it. Taste me how to do it. Everybody love me. Everybody love me. Everybody love me. Stop! You didn't listen? You did. That was pretty good. I practiced that for 3 weeks. You didn't listen? Do it yourself.
Now what are we supposed to do?
I guess we gotta introduce Court.
All right.
Brooke George. Escorted by Justice Trewin.
You're the closest Justice to Trewin.
And all I can taste is your sweet. All I can breathe is your love. Don't want to miss you anymore. And I don't want you to see me, 'cause I don't think that they'd understand the way everything's made to be broken. I just want you to know
who I am. Paulina Pullman. Escorted by Brandon Bump.
And you can't fight the tears that ain't coming. All the moment of truth in your lies. When everything feels like the movies. Yeah, you bleed just to know you're alive. And I don't want the world to see me. 'Cause I don't think they'd understand. When everything's made to be broken, I just want you to know who I am.
Alexis Herwin. Yeah. Escorted by Caleb Conan.
I know that you feel inside. You're the closest to
me. Escorted by Eli Young.
And I don't want to go home. All I can taste is this moment. And all I can breathe is your life. And sooner or later it's over. I just don't want to miss. And I don't want the world to see me, 'cause I don't think that they'd understand the way everything's made to be broken. I just want you to know who I am.
Hannah Schmidt. Escorted by Micah Yoon.
All the moment you everything feels like the movies. Yeah, you bleed just to know you're alive. And I don't want the world to see me, 'cause I don't think they'd understand when everything
Fernando Ivuvuzela, Rafael Chiki Castango, and Mike Rosenfeld. One purpose: stop Aaron from scoring.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your Winnebago Lutheran Academy boys soccer team.
Like to talk about our season a little bit, introduce our seniors. If you would have asked us about a month ago how our season was going after our third game, you would have got a kind of a gloomy answer, because after that game we were 1-2, and that game we lost to our arch rivals Kettle Moraine Lutheran in our first conference game. So we were 1-2 overall, and we were 0-1 in the conference, and in those three games we had given up 8 goals. And we knew we had dug a hole for ourselves. Well, since that game we've played 18 games, and in those 18 games we are 17-1. The one loss being to Sheboygan North, the point being style, I guess. The one loss was to Sheboygan North, which is a Division I team with 1,500 students in their school, and at the time they were 7-1-1. In those 18 games, after giving up 8 goals in the first three games, we've given up 3 goals in the last 18 games. And most importantly, in the last week and a half, we played the team that had been in first place in the conference, St. Lawrence Seminary. We defeated them. We played the team that was in fourth place, Central Wisconsin Christian, and we played Kettle Moraine Lutheran again and won all of those games, getting a little measure of revenge against Kettle, defeating them 5-0 in our last game. So the... The boys behind me here are back in first place where they belong. We have 3 games left next week, and we know we got work to do to finish off the season, but we're hoping we're going to bring home a conference championship once again. I'd like to introduce our seniors at this time. I would like to take a little extra time. You saw a little funny video there with Aaron Calkins. And Pastor Bogg mentioned that he was honorable mention All-State last year. I'm going to start with Aaron, because Aaron's had a special career here at WLA. Aaron set the school record for most goals in a season last year with 49, which led the state of Wisconsin in total points. Just hang on. There's a lot more. Currently, Aaron is again leading the state of Wisconsin with 44 goals. He has 103 goals for his career, which eclipses the old mark set last year by Tommy Knuth by 21, and he's still going. He holds the school record for most assists with 35, and he's still going. Basically, Aaron holds all offensive records here at WLA. So yeah, give him a little round of applause. But our team is not just Aaron. We have a lot of really talented players, as we have had the last several years. And Aaron knows that his achievements wouldn't have been possible without the talents of the rest of the players. But at the same time, we know that our achievements wouldn't have been possible without Aaron's hard work and his achievements. And so, Aaron, did you step forward yet? Aaron Calkins, number 9. One of our co-captains, our two other co-captains are Jordan King. And Eddie Spanbauer. Our other seniors starting on my left are statistician Liz Rohde. Statistician Hannah Schmidt. Craig Hall. Dan Priest. Sam Klein. Cole Schwartz. Aaron Egan. Brian Eaton. Eric Post, Scott Pamplin, and those are our seniors. I'd like to thank my fellow coaches this year, Assemblyman Jeremy Thiesfeldt, who assisted me on varsity, our JV coaches, Braden Fredrickson, class of 2007, and Brian Fisher, class of 2006, who have done a tremendous job coaching our JVs. I'd like to thank all our faithful fans, our wonderful parents, who have often prepared very delicious food for us to eat, which we really appreciate. I'd like to thank the cheerleaders for the cookies this last week. And we wish the cross-country team and the volleyball team and the football team continued success. Congratulate them on the successes they have had this year. And hope to see all of you at the big game tomorrow at Viking Field as we cheer the football team on to a big victory. Thank you very much.
McLaughlin, a member of the Warm Lunch Association, and I am here to discuss an important issue that is going on right here at WLA. There are some people who are not receiving a good structured lunch that like they should be, and it brings a single tear to my eye because I know that they could be eating a hot, delicious cafeteria meal. Please, people, $2.50. You,
come on, folks.
You cook lunch, people.
In the arms of an angel, take away from here, from the arms of love, a down room, fly
people, $2.50. You can have hot lunch. Come on.
$2.50, folks.
$2.50.
$2.50.
Don't be stingy. That means you, Conan.
Welcome to sophomore skit. We gotta bring it this way. Welcome to the season premiere, and probably a season finale, of Are You Smarter Than a Ninth Grader? Let's bring on our contestant all the way from Green Lake, Wisconsin, Harley Mitchley. So Harley, tell us a little about yourself. What are some of your hobbies?
Well, let's see. There's video games. Did I mention video games?
You did.
Oh.
Many times. Okay. Now, let's get down with the show. Let's introduce the teachers. First, we have Mr. Witty, music. Please stand. Thank you. Then, we have Pastor Boggs. Thank you. Okay. Then, we have Mr. Struth for religion. Now we have Mr. Klukas for history. And then more, Mr. Yeager for Phi Ed. Thank you. And then last and probably the least, Mr. Thiesfeld for algebra. Now let's get started. All right, Harley, let's look at the categories. What will be your first one?
I'm going with religion with Mr. Struce.
All right, Mr. Struce, make your way. All right, your religion question is up on the board. How would Jesus properly tie a bow tie?
I'm going to have to cheat on this one.
All right, well, let's see what Mr. Struth put. You put? There you have it, folks. That's how Jesus would tie a bow tie. You may sit down. Thank you. All right, let's go to the next categories. What would be your second category?
I'm going with music with Mr. Witty.
All right, Mr. Witty, come on down. All right, Harley, your question is, what note would this be?
That note is a G.
Mr. Witty, what do you think it is?
Can I get my Mac?
No, probably not. Well, you were correct, Harley. It is a G. Mr. Witty, you may sit down. Thank you. All right, let's go to the next categories. What would you pick?
I choose algebra with Mr. Thiesfeld.
All right, Mr. Thiesfeld, come on down. Woo. All right, Harley, your question is up on the screen. What is that? Okay.
I'm going to cheat on this one.
Of course, okay. Let's see what Mr. Thiesfeld has put. That's nothing.
Well, they're imaginary numbers.
Of course they are. All right, you can sit down. Thank you. Good try. We will go to the next category.
Let's try sports with Pastor Boggs.
All right, Pastor Boggs. All right, your question is, who lost to the New Orleans Saints in the blowout victory of the 2009 Super Bowl?
Wow, I am not a football fan. I will cheat.
Okay, Pastor Boggs.
I'm going to have to refuse that question.
I was afraid you would say that. Okay, well, it was the Indianapolis Colts. Sorry to hear that. All right, we will go to our next category.
I'll go with Fayed with Matt Behrens. I mean Mr. Jaeger, of course.
Silly. All right, your question is, how should a teacher respond when a student leaves the locker unlocked?
I'm going to tell you right now, I don't really know, so let's ask the teacher.
Let's show. Mr. Jaeger?
Well, first I'd find the student and ask him to lock it after I threw their stuff in the shower.
Ooh, that is harsh, man, harsh. All right, and we'll go to the final category of the night, history with Mr. Klukas. Okay. Mr. Klukas? All right. Who is the fastest runner in WLA history?
Well, there has been many runners that have gone to the school of
WLA.
You see. And a program has a very long, long, long history of running, you see. So, yeah.
Well, I could have stopped you earlier, but I wanted to see what you said. All right, sorry, that is all the time we have for this season. Probably not have a next one, I don't know why. But come back next season if we do have one for our Korean edition. Sorry, smarter than a ninth grader. Thank you, everybody.
I'm gonna get the awe factor, I think.
Ladies, dear WLA family, we here at WLA do not believe that TV was invented in 1997. There are many songs before, or many shows before that time with wonderful talent. Not everything here tonight should be enjoyed only by those under 27. So, seasoned Viking fans, we take this opportunity to acknowledge you and pay tribute to the Andy Griffith Show.
The Andy Griffith Show, starring Andy Griffith with Ronnie Howard. Also starring Don Knotts.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Junior Lip Sync.
Could you, hey? Hey, bump it.
Wanna be on top? Wanna be on top?
Hey, pretty boy, turn up the bass, turn up the treble. I'm about to take it to a whole nother level. DJ, turn up what you're playing. I want the whole club to hear what I'm saying. Because this girl means so much to me. Now we on the floor and she touching me. And if I wanna take her home, it's gotta be better than what they do on the radio.
It's gotta be the funkiest,
gotta be the loudest,
gotta be the best love song she ever heard in her life.
I got all the other kids with the one bad kid.
My chair. Hi, I'm Scott Pamprin. This is SportsCenter. We go to a video of Kelsey Kietzer interviewing the finest athletes at the Academy. Kelsey?
At Rosenau Elementary School, where the WLA boys soccer team is having their practice. I am standing here with a member of the soccer team, Sam Klein, also known as P. Plush on the field. So, P. Plush, how are the boys looking this year?
Oh, we are looking really good. I mean, the guys are working really hard on the Plush Mentals, and we're looking like we're going to take it to state this year.
Excellent words from P. Plush. Thank you.
I gotta go.
Now I am here with a member of WLA's cross country team, Alexis Herwig. Lexi, how is the team looking this year?
Really good. We are getting a lot better, and it's a lot of fun.
That's great. Thank you, Lexi.
You're welcome.
Here we are at the WLA gym with one of our varsity volleyball players, Aaron Isaacson. How is the varsity team looking this year?
Well, we have been having a lot of injuries lately this season. We have won 2 games so far, and so I think things are starting to look up for us.
Thank you, Aaron. Now I am here with Ben Davis, one of the captains of our WLA Vikings football team. Ben, how is the game going to go on Saturday?
Oh, we're going to win.
There you go. Here we are on Viking Field. I'm here with Mike Rosenfeld, a student at WLA. So, Mike, how do you think the game's going to go on Saturday?
I think it's going to go pretty well. I mean, the team's really working really hard, giving 110%, really conditioning themselves, staying hydrated, drinking a lot of water. I think it's really going to, their effort's going to come back to them in the end.
Mike, do you know what sport we are talking about?
I do not.
Oh, well, all right. Thank you for this interview. Back to you, Scott.
Man, she sure is something. Thanks, Kelsey. We go to commercial break, and we'll hear from a word from our sponsor, the volleyball team.
Yo, yo, come on, you know how we do, come on.
Yeah, man.
Yo, this is my house. Whose house? My house. Whose house? My court. My house. This is whose team? My team. Whose team? My dream. My team. This is whose house? My house. Whose house? My court. My house. This is whose team? My team.
Good evening. I'm Jess Grady. I'm the varsity volleyball coach. First of all, what's with the pastors around here? I graduated in 2000, my senior year. I'm still trying to get over the memory of Pastor Wright dancing to I'm Too Sexy, and now Pastor Boggs dances to this tonight. What's going on? Now I have that to get over. Anyway, I would like to start out with a couple thank yous before I introduce the team. Cheerleaders, Cookies, you're amazing. Thank you. Love them.
Clap, do something.
My other coaching staff, Ms. Steffen, I would be completely lost without you. This woman and her puke bucket are wonderful. There's a story behind it, I'm not going to get into it. Don't worry, she didn't really puke. My JV coaches, Mrs. Miller, obviously, Wendy Krieger. Freshman coaches, Mrs. Wagey, Katie Raditz. Our statisticians, you guys are a big, big, big part of this team. Marissa Cutter, Haley Husnick, thank you for all your hard work. Thank you to God, most definitely, for these beautiful women up here, for their talents, for their perseverance. God and I have had a couple conversations, however, because, oh, the injuries we have had. I need to wrap these girls up in bubble wrap and sit them down in a padded room anytime they are not playing volleyball. That's pretty much how it needs to be. With that said, we have had a very interesting year because of all of our injuries. These girls have done an amazing job working with multiple lineups. We've had a couple starters go down, so we've really had to adjust, but they've done a phenomenal job doing so. Thank you to you parents. Thank you so much for all the time that you put in, coming to support us during games, bringing your girls from A to B, getting them where they need to be. With that, I guess we'll introduce the team. I'll talk us. Oh, right. We are 3-2 in conference, which is good. We kind of wish we could have the North Fond du Lac game back, but that's okay. We'll get the next couple. We do play Mayville here at home Tuesday night, so we would love it if you'd come and support us, cheer us on. As far as introducing the girls, we do have two freshmen on the team. Cassie, would you please step forward? Cassie Krieger! And given all our craziness on the team, our injuries and need for more bodies, darling Shelby Zilke has stepped up and done an amazing, amazing job for us. Thank you, ladies. Our sophomore on the team is Sarah Kell. Starting with our juniors, we have Miss Abby Hilbert, Lizzie Pruss, Sammy Krause, Bethany Westfall. On to our seniors. First of all, my captains. Are they not stunning? And I'm obviously talking about Brooke George and Amy Leibsite. You are simply gorgeous. All right, my other seniors. I have Miss Martha Marker, Aaron Isaacson, Jordan Wagey, Miss Michaela McFarlane. We definitely want to wish a huge good luck to the other fall sports, specifically football. Good luck tomorrow, you guys. Go get them. I said it last year. I'm going to say it this year. 110%. No regrets. Leave everything on the field and cherish those memories for the rest of your life, okay? Good luck, guys. Monday night, October 3rd, any female who likes to play volleyball, we have alumni night, an alumni volleyball game this Monday at 6:30. Varsity Girls will be your officials. There will be refreshments, there will be prizes. Any moms of current players are welcome to come and play. And the exact words are, dust off the court shoes, grab the Bengay, and join the fun. 6:30, Monday night.
The bird is a plane, no, it's Dwight Howard. Touch the cloud, make it rain like you just showered. I got 1 hour just to go hard.
Hi, folks. I love Jesus. I love my family. I love the students here at WLA. I love the alumni, the friends, but there's folks sitting around here that are still a little bit shorter than me, most of them. And I'm in it for you. And if I wasn't a pastor, I would have probably have been a lounge singer right now on a cruise ship somewhere, singing show tunes. And so I've tried to figure out how I can put my two loves, my two passions, together. Sorry, wake up. And what I've been working on for the last 3 or 4 weeks or so is trying to put together a new WLA recruitment song. And I knew that it was TV shows, and I was going through all the themes. And to be honest with you, I'm sad tonight to admit to all of you that as of yet, I haven't been able to come up with something yet. Ooh. Mr. Witte, how are you?
I'm doing fine.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
What are you doing here?
Just hanging out.
Well, you're the man. You're the person that would be able to help me come up with a song that I just happen to have the words for right here. Mr. Witte, if you have an idea of any song that I could sing to that kid, and to that kid, and to those kids who it's too dark over there to see, do you have any ideas?
Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. How about coming to WLA? Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name. Billets, Hag, and Stephane. You wanna be where you can see our troubles are all the same. You wanna be with folks like Dan Detmain.
I'm gonna cry.
Principal's nice and Brad is too, and Randy's a big wig.
Walk through the halls and ease your worries. What's up with Scott Herwig? Klukas is not an easy A, or I've been told he is. Sometimes you wanna go to a school that we call WLA. In the office are Julie and Lorray. You wanna be where Lutherans be, Joachim and Lil Ben Gore. Hey, it rhymed. You wanna be where everybody knows your name. You wanna go where people know people are all the same. You wanna go where everybody knows your name. Your name. Please welcome the dance team.
All about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plate said, "Freshen it a dice in the mirror." If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, "Nah, forget it, yo, home's the Bel Air."
You wanna be on?
Yep.
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 Oh, man, dang on, man. Yeah, we got Kale Corner and Courtman. Oh, dang on. Here's a junior skit.
Guys, get off the courts.
All rise for Judge Judy.
I already am.
Please be seated. All right, let's open up the case between Zahn and Witty. What's the dealio here, gents?
Well, he...
Music. Hey, knock it off. Okay, Witty, you go ahead.
Well, as you can see right here, Pastor Zahn...
Ouch! Right in the eyes.
Sorry. Pastor Zahn thinks that the football team is far more important to Winnebago Lutheran Academy than the music program. But you can probably notice that the three choral concerts have about way more attendance than the nine football games.
That's because we lost Ian. He's a state champ, you know.
We have Jonathan.
Ian.
Jonathan.
Ian.
Jonathan!
Football!
Music!
Football!
Music!
Hey. Back it off. Back to your stands.
Zahn, you've got the floor.
Football! Touchdown!
That's it?
Yep.
All right. I guess that means it's time for us to bring on our first witness, Mr. Paul Thiesfeld, coming up. All right, Mr. Thiesfeld. We need your help here. We've got Pastor Zahn, who thinks that the football program is more important than the music program, and Mr. Witty here at WLA. So, what do you think?
Well, Judge, I drew out this complex algebraic equation, if you let me show you.
Go ahead.
Now, little Johnny here, as you can see, little Johnny... Let's say F times x equals 4, g times x equals 16, and you take this whole thing times the picture of a bear, and then right here, you get football plus or minus music equals, well, we don't know. Have I ever told you about my son, David?
Okay, where is this going?
Well, I'm just trying to show you.
You know what? I don't even want to hear it. Get out. Go. Take your whiteboard. Go. Thank you. Good riddance. Okay. Next up, we've got, let's see here, Pastor Bradley Wright.
Well,
all right, now that everyone can see you, Pastor Wright, we need your opinion on the football music matter.
Well, you know, I am not involved in either of those sports. But, well, anyone, does anyone want to help me with this situation?
I don't think anyone's going to help you, so you want to just give your opinion? That'd be really great.
Well, I'm going to have to go with football.
Okay, thank you very much. You are dismissed.
Hey, put me down for a second. I got to check something. Hold on. Whoa, what is this?
That was totally useless, but I think our next witness should be a big old help. Big man on campus here at WLA, please welcome Damon Sturba. How you doing, Damon?
Good.
Feels good to be in your presence right now. Just one sec.
Thanks for coming in today, Damon.
Okay, Damon, we need your help. We've got Pastor Zahn here, who thinks football is more important at WLA. You're a big guy here, so than Mr. Witte's music program. So can you help us out a little bit?
Soccer?
Damon, if you weren't so beautiful, I'd throw you out of this courtroom right now. All right, we're going to go through this one more time, real slow-like, okay? Pastor Zahn, football. Mr. Witte, music.
Football.
Ian. Case closed! Football. Goes to Pastor Zahn and football.
Ian, football. Jesus. Ian, football. Jesus. Jesus. Yeah.
Pastor Zahn, you just won the case.
What? I won! We're all done.
Feeling small when tears are in your eyes, I will dry them all. Thank you.
turn it on while I'm watching the video.
The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV. Did I get delivered here? Somebody tell me, please. This old world confused me. Clouds as mean as you've ever seen. And a bird who knows your tune. Then a little voice inside you whispers.
The cast of Full House.
I'm DJ Tanner.
And I'm Danny Tanner.
Joey!
Cut it out.
Well, usually this is where we would introduce the freshman lip sync, but they don't have one this year.
Yeah. Mike, Joey, could you explain to me why they don't have a...
They got no self-discipline.
Joey!
All right, well, to make the situation a little lighter, let's watch us again.
In a world of walkers, few dare to run. Even fewer dare to run for the Winnebago Lutheran Academy cross-country team. Recently, four young WLA students, well, three young WLA students and a middle-aged bald guy, ventured into the seedy world of competitive running. Here is their story. They took training seriously. They took fashion even more seriously. Finally, it was time to compete. WLA Cross Country. Enter at your own risk.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome perhaps the bravest people on our campus, the Winnebago Lutheran Academy Cross Country Team.
Good evening. This is the 2011 cross-country team, boys and girls. First of all, we also, like the other teams, would like to thank especially the cheerleaders tonight for the things they've done this week, especially the cookies that the kids got after chapel the other day. Thank you very much. We also want to wish the best of seasons to our soccer team, volleyball team, as they enter playoffs in a few weeks, and the football team tomorrow. It is, we talked about this in social class this week, it is important to win the homecoming game. This school has a history of losing homecoming games. You win the homecoming game. The girls at the dance are prettier if you win the homecoming game. Their hair smells better if you win the homecoming game. Let's get them. This year's cross country team is sort of an interesting mix. We had almost all of our girls back from last year's team, and we have a team just east of town, 2 miles, that's probably going to win the state championship, St. Mary Springs Girls. So within our conference, our goal this year is to take second in our conference. A week ago down at Horicon, all the conference schools were there, sort of a pre-conference meet, and we came in second, a solid second place at that meet. And our goal is a week from 2 weeks from yesterday, a week from this coming Thursday, we'll go over to Laconia and have the conference meet. That's one we've been shooting at the whole season. And we aim and hope to run our best meet of the year there, and our girls, hopefully, will take the second place at that conference meet. A little bit about the conference girls team. At Sheboygan, we were fourth out of 21 schools. Horicon, second out of eight, like I said. Princeton, just last Tuesday, third out of 14. And yesterday down at Slinger, on a muddy course, we took second out of 10. I wanted you to just to hear that so you can see that we've been more than competitive this year. Usually in the top third at most meets, sometimes even a little better than that. On the guys' side of the ledger, we have an entirely different case. For the boys' team, we lost 6 senior runners last year. 4 of those were our top 6 runners. And so we had sort of a rebuilding team coming in. And what's been fun to watch is this young group of some inexperienced and some very gifted runners come together and become a very competitive team as the season's gone on. Our goal at conference is to be in the hunt. There's about 4 or 5 schools at the conference meet. Ourselves, St. Lawrence, Springs, Laconia, Lamira, and us. We should be in the hunt anywhere from 1 to 5 on any given day. And 2 weeks from yesterday, we'll find out where that is. The best thing about our cross-country team this year, in my view, and I've shared this with 3 or 4 parents at a number of meets, is this is a team that has total respect for each other. And you do not get that in all sports in every year. And I think the reason for that is we have 4 senior runners and a senior captain who really give up the respect to the freshmen on the team. On the girls' side of the ledger, we have some girls that go back and forth every meet, from varsity to JV, from JV to varsity. And there is absolutely no envy whatsoever. There is respect for the people who earn those spots. There is not jealousy. There is not envy. It's just a really, really neat thing to see. And the parents notice it. We as the coaches notice it. It's just a great, great thing. I think that's attributable to our senior class, and I'd like to introduce those right now. We'll start with the best dressed first. We have Lexi Herwing, our captain. Also a 4-year runner, we have Polina Pullman. We also have Bella Schaefer. And Kaylee Coleman. And our manager, is she here? Caroline, right in the middle. Caroline Flood. 3-year runner, 1-year manager. Like I said, these girls have set the tone as seniors. The boys team has no seniors at all. We have juniors, sophomores, and freshmen. And just really, really fun to watch both teams improve individually, but also as a team as we go through our season. Last thing I'd like to do is probably should have been done first, and that is to thank the coaches. We have Don Kerr, Joel Mathwing, and we also have Tammy Coleman, who helps us out when she can at both practices and meets. We also should give a round of applause to Joel. He has been married tomorrow 2 weeks. Right? Two? Sorry, three. Three. Like I said, homecoming is a good time for everybody to come back, renew acquaintances, and tomorrow, if the Lord blesses us with good weather, which I think is in the forecast, we should have a great time Saturday afternoon. And Vikings, let's get a victory over North Fond du Lac tomorrow.
That's just an angry, angry, angry crowd. I pulled this off the shelf, I wore it. There are a few possessions in life that you really get excited about. There's maybe your 2002 Buick Park Avenue with heated seats. There's your 42-inch big screen TV, which makes sports come alive. There's your kids. For the last 8 years, this has been one of my proudest possessions. This is my golf ball globe that I keep in my office each and every day, in which students from my previous school in WLA try to master. Some do. Some are horrible. Danny Bates. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to give one of them, because it's taking up too much room in my office, and it's time for me to move on to something like a soccer golf ball globe. I am going to give, in the spirit of game shows, one of the seniors the opportunity to win this. We do not have time to play Minute to Win It, so we are going to play 20 Seconds to Win It. I've got the names of a bunch of seniors in here. I'm going to give one of you the opportunity. Aiden, would you please pick it out of there? Just one name. Aiden, do not lie. Who is the name? Yell it loud.
Michaela McFarland.
Michaela McFarland, are you here? Come out here really quick. Hurry up. Have you ever been able to get this?
Once.
Don't lie. Have you ever been able to get this?
Yeah, I got it.
Don't lie. You have 20 seconds. If you can do this, it's yours. Go.
Okay.
So far, you haven't done anything. 15. 13, there's 900 people watching you, look up. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, October, November, December. Wait there, one more try. Don't leave with it. We're gonna give one more student, this is it. Would you please, please announce the name of who this is. Into the microphone.
Michaela McFarland.
People, I'm not going to lie to you. I love the snow globe. I pick someone I know could never, ever do it. Please welcome the senior lip sync.
Thank you.
I'm shuffling.
Hey, teach me how to dug it, hey. They be like smooth, what? Can you teach me how to dug it? You know why? Cause all the girls love it, hey. All I need is a beat that's super bumpin', and for you, you to bag it up and dump it.
Yeah. Teach me how to dug it. Teach me how to dug it. Teach me how to dug it. Teach me how to dug it.
Everybody love me. Everybody love me. Everybody love me. You ain't messing with my duggie.
You really know how to dance. When you go up, down, jump around, talk about your romance. Yeah.
Could switching to Geico really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Does Mr. Klukas like to wear a red tie?
Good morning, sir. Good. Good. All right. Good morning, Scott. Good morning, Mr. Happy Friday.
Yep.
Hey, Mr. Good morning, Scott. How are you doing today? Good. Good to see you.
Could switching to Geico really save you 15% or more on car insurance? It's the plot of this year's freshman skit and revolve around them running around the set in a circular motion like a duck swimming with one leg cut off. You tell me.
This is yet another stupid freshman skit. Please save the booing till the end. Welcome to the Wheel of Fortune. We have an exciting game for you tonight. There's been an accident with the board, so we have blank, blank, will defeat, blank, blank. Our contestants tonight are Elmer Fudd, the Powerpuff Girls, and Yogi Bear. Okay, Elmer Fudd, you're up first.
Where's my rabbit?
Don't worry, Elmer. There is no rabbit here. I promise. But we are going to move on to the Powerpuff Girls.
We would like to buy the vowel K.
What did you say?
The vowel K? Duh. No, genius. It's...
Yeah, vowel isn't a K! K is not a vowel!
Okay, calm down, girls. This is a happy show. Okay, we're going to have to go over to Yogi Bear.
I know. Miss Stefan will defeat all freshmen.
Wow, you guys are doing horrible at figuring this thing out. Almost as bad as the freshman skit last year, but nobody can do that bad. Does anybody know what the answer is? Anybody?
Yeah, I know. It's the Vikings will defeat the Orioles.
That's correct.
I told you there was a rabbit here.
Well, that's all, folks. Have a good night and watch out for rabbits.
Guys, we're in trouble. MCs, get over here. Hurry up, quickly. Big cheerleading mishap. Big mishap. The cheerleaders working out were throwing Michaela Wright into the air, and she hit her head on the ceiling. She came down, squashed Steph Holmes. They need two of us to do the routine with them tonight. Do you guys got it? Wait a second. Whoa. Why do you guys already have cheerleading outfits on, matching outfits? What about me? I'm with you guys.
Here, throw on this quick. Put it on.
I can't wear this in public.
Yeah, put it on.
Wait!
Go bike! Yeah!
Go bike! Yeah, I like it!
Woo! Yeah!
Do you have anything prepared, Pastor Boggs?
Look at me. Does it look like I have a cheer prepared? What about you? Try one.
Okay, top of my head, here's an idea. Tell me what you think. Roller coaster! Roller coaster! All right, here we go. Here we go. Yeah! Hi, Mom! What do you think?
That was dumb.
All right, you got any better ideas?
Yeah, well, I have my personal favorite. It goes a little something like this. Phil, he's our man. If he can't do it, great!
It's all right.
Okay, well, I've been working on a little something. Dun 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 dun. I like big muscles and I cannot lie. You soccer players can't deny that when a guy walks in with really big arms and you cannot acquire, you get jealous. Go Vikes.
Yeah. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, the WLA cheerleaders. Oh, I just pulled her hair off.
Did you see her smack her head?
Good evening. Is this on? Testing, okay, sorry. I'm not very techie wise, I guess, here. Notes, so I don't forget anything. First of all, great job, ladies. And an A-plus for carrying on when the music skipped a bit. I want to thank family and friends for coming tonight to share this great fun evening with our kids. I want to thank the rest of the Skit Night people for their great entertainment. The dance team for a wonderful spaghetti dinner last night, and some of our cheer moms who fed us well with the taco bar tonight. Thank you very much. I want to wish the soccer team, cross country, volleyball, much success as you complete your season. Football, let's show those Orioles who's boss tomorrow, okay? Okay. Cheerleaders really love to do push-ups, so let's see how high we can get that score. I have a special thanks tonight to my coaching staff, and I'm not sure exactly where they disappeared to. Stand up, please. Miss Scharf, Ashley Lost, and Emily Krug. All three of these great helpers were out here on homecoming for 4 years while they were in high school. So they've been come back. They've really helped me this season. I've had a lot of family issues, so they've really picked up the slack and been my support system. So I thank you very, very much. And now, and now for our seniors. Are you ready? Catch your breath. Okay. We started a tradition. Senior stunts. First, we have Caitlin Kepsel. Yeah. Caitlin is our homecoming captain and was a lead choreographer for the routine you just watched. Thank you. And next we have, and as soon as they're in their stunt, I'll give you their names from my left to the right. Three more seniors who are great help getting this routine together. Steph Holmes, Becky Meyer, and Amy Qualman. Becky is also a senior captain. And next, breathe. We have our own. Go ahead, Katie Bach. Yeah. And behind her, Sarah Newman. Two more great assets to our team. And not quite last, definitely not the least, we have Micaiah Mildebrandt and Chelsea Trapp. That's why we have mats. And last but not least, maybe the littlest, we have another senior captain, Michaela Wright. Can I have one more round of applause for these girls, please? And we'll roll up the mats. Thank you all. Have a happy homecoming weekend.
And we want to thank you, captains, for teaching us everything that we've known for the last years. And I know this week has been really rough for Darcy, and you guys really stepped up to take her spot and help her a lot. We just wanted to say thank you.
Where's Marta? Thank you.
In 5, 4, 3, 2.
I was on my way to the store the other day, and
what'd you get?
Can I finish the story? So when I got to the store, I realized I had forgotten all of my money.
Oh, I thought that's what happened.
Can I ever finish one dang story?
Your stories are lame, Mike.
Hey, you don't talk to me.
Oh,
like that.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Oh, these potatoes are
bad.
Why are these potatoes full? I wanted more potatoes.
I'm in physics class. I am in physics class, and that is a weighted class.
So, Kelsey, did you bring my soccer ball?
No, I didn't. Sorry.
Well, you know I had practice after school.
Well, I said I was sorry.
I wish you weren't a liar.
I wish you wouldn't call me a liar.
I wish you just weren't a liar.
Oh, my God.
Hey, you don't talk to her like that.
Oh, here we go.
Talk. Why is that like that?
On the north wall.
Why is that on the north wall?
I said it should have been on the south wall.
I drive a Dodge Stratus.
You know what? I think I'm just going to go hang out with Moose tonight.
Yeah, I suppose you do that.
Be quiet, you field fairy.
Hey, you! Don't talk to him like that.
Why is this chicken dog?
I blame Omo Roman. Okay, just thank you guys a meal.
I've been with Moose for 4 years!
Okay, can we at least try and have a good dinner this night? You know, let's just watch some TV. Why don't we just do that? I heard the sophomore lip sync is on.
Relaxing all cool and all shooting some b-ball outside of the pool when a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it."
Okay. Anything for cheap applause. I like the Colts. I like the Packers. I have been to a Monday night football game at Lambeau Field
and one sound, we'll see if this works, that I will never ever forget is this. Boom, boom, ba bo bo boom.
Go, Pack, go!
One more time. Boom, boom, ba bo bo boom.
Go, Pack, go!
Ladies and gentlemen, again, the dance team.
Okay, it's working. Good evening to all of you. Thank you for coming and enjoying this evening with us. I want to thank all my parents. I have wonderful dance parents this year. I'm so blessed. Thank all of you for all your help. I want to give special thanks to the Pep Band, who just really isn't recognized often enough, for their role in our football games, our skit night, and also our basketball games. And Mr. Witte, thank you so much. Without you, I don't know what we would do with all our music. Thank you. Let's give Mr. Witte a big hand. I'd like to thank the sound people as well, and Andy for the lighting, helped us with our black lights, and there's just so many people to thank. The cheerleaders for the cookies this week. So I've got a great team this year. I've really been blessed. I have three seniors. I'd like to call them up. Shelby and Melissa. Shelby Becker and Melissa Wolf. The reason I call them up together is because they come as a set. They've been dancing since fifth grade for Wells Junior Dance and then now on for 4 years at WLA. They are awesome leaders. They're senior captains, and this team just has heart this year. I think they're going to do so well during our season and during competition. They're just a great team, and I think a lot of it, like I said, is due to their leadership. So good going, girls. Our last senior is Jesse Yee. Jesse has been with us. This is her second year and has really been such an asset to our team. Thank you, Jesse. I'd like to also thank, and I can't forget this, my coaches, Amy Bear. Where are you, Amy? I'm blinded by the light. Okay, Amy gave us a special gift this year. She brought another little dancer into the world. Little Ava was born in the beginning of August and has been recruited. You know, she's a good dancer, we know for sure. And also Jessica Surway, who without her, we would just be lost. She just contributes a lot to the team. I guess my captains, would you like to say something? Come on up.
We would just like to thank our coaches, Linda Ferris and Jessica Surway, and it wouldn't have looked like this at all if we did not have their help and everything. We'd also like to thank the girls for working so hard this week. It was a very hectic week, and they all put through. Andy Franklin for the choreography, and the parents for all their hard work, and for feeding us and letting us stay at their houses, and thank you. Go Vikes!
Just one last thing. Andy Franklin, raise your hand. Andy choreographed the individual routines, and a special thank you to Melissa and Shelby who choreographed this routine. So good job, girls. Good luck to our football game, our football team tomorrow. Let's win that game.
It begins as a freshman when you do your skit and most of the people boo. During sophomore year, maybe your parents clap, grandma and grandpa clap even though they don't understand any of what you just did, and the little kids just sit there and say, this is getting long. Junior year, you think you've got it down. And so you start doing things and you go through the motions and there's some big laughs and then you come off stage and some of your friends go, why did you ad-lib? That wasn't funny. But then it comes to senior year. And I'm standing backstage right now with seniors who know what they're doing. Seniors who are funny and talented. And to be honest with you, a little scared to death to come out on stage right now. Without further ado, what I am certain is going to be the best student skit of the night. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome the senior skit.
Help, help, Victor is sick.
What seems to be the matter?
Our mascot Victor is sick and we need him tomorrow for the homecoming game.
Okay, we'll see what we can do.
Huh, no. Close but not close enough, janitor. Sounds like he's winning. I think he's come down with a little case of Charlie Sheen.
This is serious.
I got tiger blood. Agent Archer. Tiger blood.
This is serious. We need Dr. House.
What?
We need your help, please.
Let's see what I can do for this freak.
Oh!
Cherry.
I'm sorry to report that the national debt has now become a number that is unknown. As the nation's scientists and math teachers wonder, what comes after trillion? In an attempt to decrease the national debt, the president has decided to give the Jersey Shore to China. And now an ultrasonic message for our pets. Thank you. And now we'll talk about the football game. Maybe not. You may be wondering how many jokes I plan to bring into this little news break. The answer is 12. Most of them are written in between the lines. If anyone can read in between the lines, most can't. Moving on. That brings us to the end of our news segment. And just a reminder, everyone here should tune in at 11 to learn the deadly truths about oxygen. Thank you.
What's going on here, Dwight?
This is weird.
It's an office war, Briggs.
Well, be careful.
Very careful.
I will be, little one.
Go down, go down. Oh, this is almost as painful as watching the freshman skit.
Wow! What a wound!
Hey there, Tim! It's been a while, almost a week.
Yeah, I know, almost a week.
I don't think so, Tim.
What have you been up to?
Well, I was helping the seniors construct this wonderful backdrop when Victor glued this board to my head.
Oh, I don't think so, Tim. That is not what happened.
Yeah, actually, Victor's been here all day. I should probably go check on him.
Should do something. Some Vicodin. Maybe we could rub lotion on his feet. Hit him with a really hard stick. Down. Check his garbly-goo levels.
What?
Check him again. I need the magic spray for his face.
Oh, I know you're not touching my mannequin.
I will now administer the spray to his body. Live. Live, you freak. He's alive.
Like I said, folks, freshman year, you struggle. Sophomore year, who knows, junior year, senior year, you nail it every single time. Give him another round of applause, or at least a first round of applause, please. Seniors, I'll tell you the names of the freshmen who were booing you right after the ceremonies tonight. We're in the fourth quarter. We've got about 8 minutes left. WLA is up on North Fond du Lac 62-3. And we're about to introduce to you the team that's going to do that tomorrow. We have four leader captains on our team. And I've asked them, and they're going to be brought out, and Coach is going to talk about the seniors and introduce the seniors to you. But one of the most fun things that I get to do at WLA is help coach football. I get to be around, throw passes, legally yell at kids. So it's a very, it's a fun time of my ministry. And tonight, I'd like to introduce you quickly to our senior captains. First of all, would Jim Krug please come out here? Give him a round of applause. Oh, yeah, it was special. Jimmy, what do you have to say about the game tomorrow?
I think it should go pretty well. I've been working pretty hard in practice all week. Should be ready to go.
Thank you for using your deep voice with my first tenor voice. That's very nice, Jim. Jim, I brought you out here, though, not only to talk about football tonight. I'd like to talk to you quickly about relationships, Jim. And I'm concerned about your relationship. Because I see you guys walking through the halls. You look scared of Marta Kerr. Is that true?
A little.
Has she ever pushed you into a locker?
Yeah.
Has she ever made you feel like a wee little man cowering in fear in the corner?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, senior lineman Jimmy Krug. They only get bigger and meaner from here. Ladies and gentlemen, give a round of applause to senior captain Ben Davis. Hey, what are you? Mr. Davis.
Ben.
Mr. Davis.
Ben.
Ben. You're his father. You're not the captain of the football team.
I'm Ben. Absolutely.
No, you're not.
Most certainly am.
You're Mr. Davis.
I'm Ben.
You're huge.
Yes, I am.
But you're still Mr. Davis.
I'm Ben.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, Ben Davis. Oh, geez. Well. It's going to take four men and a crane to get that jersey off here after this tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, no team works without its quarterback. Please welcome senior quarterback Matt Behrens. Matt, how are you doing tonight? What do you feel about the game tomorrow?
It's going to be good. We're going to win.
Matt, did you lock your locker this night tonight?
No, and apparently Mr. Yeager throws stuff in the shower. So I better go lock it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Matt Behrens. Give him a round of applause, please. And finally, most of our captains are human beings. One is a field creature. Please give a big round of applause to Moose. Where are you, Moose? Moose, come on out. Kelsey?
Hey.
This is wrong on so many levels. I don't even know what to say. A, you're a girl. B, you have sparkly eyelashes. You're not on the football team. You're not Moose.
Oh, yeah? You want to bet?
Ladies and gentlemen, the football team!
Here comes the, here comes the, here comes the,
y'all don't really worry like that.
Here comes the, here comes the, here comes the,
y'all don't really worry like that.
Here comes the, here comes the, here comes the,
y'all don't really worry like that.
Double L, I said so. I keep big bills up in my heart on the dirty like blood. So ain't got no twist in my head, but I'm still dreadful. And I got plenty of bread, so I go to bed for a line. In it to win it, to win it, I'm all in. I might call you my cousin.
I don't know what to say after all this. I'll tell you one thing. We have what's called a formation called the unbalanced line. The new Ben Davis is welcome to join the unbalanced line tomorrow. He was pretty good in his day, too. First of all, before we talk about the football, guys, I want to thank the cheerleaders for the great cookies that we received this week. The dance team for their spaghetti dinner. That was great also. And most importantly, the parents who bring these guys from all different parts of the state, so to speak, to not only come to school, but able to bring them for football, for their other sports, other activities, and that's something that we really appreciate. I want to thank the coaches, Coach Herwig, Coach Zahn, Coach Stepman, Coach Voss, Coach Yeager, Coach Wilcox, our two statsmen, Pastor Gertner and Paul Kasten, and Joe Lamb for doing all the work he does on the camera. I unfortunately left out Pastor Boggs because I just got a phone call earlier this evening that he is going to be on Dancing with the Stars, so he'll be leaving us. Want to commend the cross-country people, boys and girls, the volleyball team, the soccer team, for the fall sports, for the successes, and for the hard work that they put in. Each person has their talent to be able to participate in the sports that they've chosen to do, and I appreciate the hard work that they put in for their sports, and they are to be commended. I also like to thank once more our athletic director, who takes care of all these things, and then on the side he teaches and as well as trying to coach soccer in the spring. And Mr. Hoffman does a fantastic job with that, so I want to appreciate the work he does. When I watched the cheerleaders do their cheer this evening, it kind of reminded me back in the day when my wife was a cheerleader for Racine Lutheran, and it was go fight win. Things have changed a little bit over the years as to how cheerleaders work, but they just do a fantastic job with all the choreography and so forth that they have. One of our goals this year was to make the playoffs, and we've had a few other goals, and as the season goes, sometimes you have to change those goals. That goal is still in mind. We're 2-4 at this point in time, but at the same time, three of our losses were to ranked teams. When I say that, there's also no excuses. You go out and you play the game and you try and win. And our kids have worked very hard at it and have shown up. And the biggest thing, and it's something that you're always looking for as a coach, is that we don't quit. And these guys play four quarters, and I really appreciate that. We have a game coming up tomorrow against a bunch of my former students, which is kind of interesting for me. I used to teach in North Fond du Lac, and I know all those kids on that team, and I'm rooting for them to lose. I know what good kids they are, but I've got a great group of kids here, too. these guys have come out and they're putting their numbers and names on the line, playing a sport where you got to be tough. Every sport, like I said, has something that's unique to that sport. And in this sport, you got to be tough. There's nothing like football that shows you graphically falling down, getting knocked down, and having to get back up and get after it again. And these guys are working at it. Their goal is to make the playoffs at this point and then move on from there. And yet, it all starts with tomorrow. We appreciate the roller coaster and all those other cheers that go on during the game so that these guys can get pumped up and be able to play their best tomorrow. So we appreciate all the support that parents, family, students, and everybody has given them. Okay, right now I'd like to introduce the seniors. As you see, we've got all of our sophomores through seniors up here, but the seniors want to go through. I won't need to talk about the captains much. You met part of them. Number 5, Matt Behrens, would you step out? One of our captains. Number 25, Phil Gertner. Number 33, Brandon, is that his first name? Brandon Bump. Josh Canmiller, number 35. Alex Hine, number 52. Corey Detman, number 54. James Park, number 70. Paul Pacetti, number 72. Captain Jim Krug, number 79. Captain Scott Davis, number 82. Oh, excuse me, Ben Davis. Number 87, Brett Scare. And number 89, Eli Jans. Thanks once again, and their part of homecoming is to do their best tomorrow at the game. We hope the score is what I heard before, but we'll take anything with a W behind it. Thank you.
Just like to say a quick thank you to all of our coaches who spend all their time, jobs or not. It's a lot of time to be spending with kids like us. Half the time we can be crabby. They can get crabby sometimes too, but we still like them all. But we would just like to say thank you for all the time that they spend with us the first couple weeks. It's a lot of hours here for the first part of the day, but just like to say thank you from all the guys here, and let's go get a win tomorrow.
I'm killing it like a blind man reading. I'm feeling it like, oh yeah.
Hi, welcome to Heaven's Kitchen, formerly known as Hell's Kitchen, before my anger management. But that's another story. I have 2 rules in my kitchen. 1, follow the recipe. 2, and for heaven's sake, build the salt. Now, let's meet our contestants.
Oh wow, this is really making me nervous. Sometimes, when I get nervous, I take my hands like this, and then I rub my armpits like that, and then I look around, and then I sniff them like this. Tell myself that I'm a superstar.
Hi, my name is Mike Rosenfeld. I'm a sharpshooter with a go-getter attitude, and I'm in this to win this.
Sugar.
Hi, I'm Mr. Billets, and welcome to Heaven's Kitchen. And now let's meet our contestants. On my right, we have Kelsey Keitzer. And on my left, we have Mike. Now today, we're going to be competing on who can make the best cake. Begin now. Counterclockwise. Counter. There you go. Counter.
Oh, thank you.
There you go.
Thank you, Mr. Bell.
Nice and easy. There you go. There you go. All right.
Good. Thank you.
Gentle, Kelsey. Gentle, gentle. You don't want to slice your finger. We all know how that is.
Oh, shoot. Kelsey, I spilled the salt. If Mr. Billet sees, he'll have another anger attack. Here he comes.
Now, Mike, what did you do here?
Oh, spilled the salt.
And what was one of my rules?
Don't spill the salt.
Yeah. I specifically told you, you'll have your turn! Eighth of an inch short. So what do we have here, Kelsey?
Oh, well, I got the, the white cake that I like, and I put a nice coat of fresh white frosting on it.
Yeah, what did the recipe call for?
Blue.
Yeah, that's right, blue! And what is this?
It's water.
Thanks! Get out! Ladies and gentlemen, the faculty skit.
Grace, you got it all over the place. You have to clean it up.
Oh, shoot. Oh, shoot.
The faculty was assigned classic TV shows for our skit. But of course, the problem with that is that everyone under 40 years old has no idea what the show is that our skit is based on, so we have a little introduction. Our skit is not based on the 70s show, but our show debuted during the 70s. The 70s, a very bad decade. Bad decade for fashion. That's how people dressed. That's how men dressed in the 70s. That's how women dressed in the 70s. These are the kind of shoes people wore. So if you had the misfortune of graduating from high school in, let's say, 1977-ish, this is what your graduation picture might have looked like. Or this. Nice leisure suit, Mr. Kerr. Or even worse, your graduation picture might have looked like this. I've been trying to burn those pictures for 34 years. That's me. The 70s, a very bad decade. Bad decade for movies. Bad decade for music. But it was a great decade for shows, including the classic TV show MASH. Our skit tonight is based on MASH, which stands for Mobile Army Surgical Hospital. Set in the Korean War, it featured doctors who were actually soldiers and who had to deal with a lot of stress and a lot of wounded coming in all the time. And so they dealt with it with humor, and it was one of the funniest shows ever. Featuring Colonel Blake, the kind of bumbling, sort of bumbling, lovable leader of the hospital. His right-hand man, Radar O'Reilly, Corporal O'Reilly, who always knew what was going to happen before it happened. That's why he was called Radar. Corporal Klinger, who always dressed in a dress because he was trying to convince his superiors that he was crazy because he was trying to get out of the Army. The two main characters were Trapper John and Hawkeye, who were always engaging in some kind of shenanigans and getting in trouble with their superiors. Frank Burns and Hot Lips Houlihan, who were the strict go-by-the-book types who were always angry at Colonel Blake. And the last character in our skit tonight is going to be Father McCahey, the lovable Catholic priest who was sort of the spiritual leader of the MASH unit. Our story begins one night as we peek in on Mr. Klukas. It's a late night, Mr. Klukas's apartment. He's surfing his TV channels. Oh, and he's watching a rerun of one of his favorite old shows, MASH, as he drifts off to sleep. And in his hazy dream world, MASH becomes WLA.
Your attention, please. Just a reminder, today we are on our normal schedule with 11-minute homerooms and 20-minute flex.
Radar!
Yes, sir!
Don't sneak up on me. How did you know I wanted you?
Oh, I knew you wanted me, and you wanted to know about your itinerary for the...
I want to know my itinerary.
Yes. What am I doing? I brought your itinerary.
What am
First
I doing?
Everybody in the camp loves you. Everybody around the camp loves you.
Yeah.
So really, all you need to do today is watch some YouTube videos and take a nap.
I'll watch YouTube videos, and I'll nap, and I'll go fishing.
Good plan. But you also
Do I have to sign anything?
You need to sign your papers, yes.
All right. How do I sign this?
Just put your initials right next to your initials.
What am I initialing?
Top secret.
How do I know it's top secret?
It looked like it.
Okay. There we go.
Your attention, please. Just a reminder, today we are on our intramural schedule with no homerooms and 36-minute flex.
This thing is not working at all. I hate Captain Pierce and Honeycutt, sir.
Just send them in.
Hawkeye, I want to talk to him? Colonel, this new schedule, it stinks. I'm in flex all the time. Flex, flex, flex. If I flex anymore, I'm going to get a cramp.
Hey, Hawkeye's right. This new schedule makes the senior skit look advanced.
Do we We have a new schedule.
What was that pie thing anyway? The pie?
We have a new schedule?
Yes, you sign for it.
Oh, we have a new schedule.
We have a new schedule, and I hate it. I hate it. I hate it.
That's a lot of hates. Hate's a strong word.
Hate. I hate the new schedule.
That's stress. Man is stressed out. I can't believe the stress we're under here.
I can't get my golf in with all the flex.
I could not show the video of my kid walking to the wall. The kids love that video. I didn't have time with all this flex stuff.
Radar, fix that. Do something. Get it done.
I'm right on it. Right on it.
Your attention, please. Just a reminder, today we are on our special Lyceum schedule with no homerooms and no flex.
Major Burns and Houlihan, sir.
Major.
Colonel.
Colonel, Major.
Colonel, Captain, Captain, Colonel, Colonel, Captain.
Corporal.
Major. Don't forget the captains.
Corporal. Captain, 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 Colonel, 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 Captain. Colonel.
Major.
So, Colonel, I see you're making a mess of everything, and you want me to come in and save you like you're a mother, and I'm not going to do it this time again. I've had enough of this. I'm out of here. Maybe Hot Lips can help you.
Well, somebody needs to get control around here. What's going to happen?
Radar?
You signed for that also, sir.
All right, I signed for it. Make it happen.
Where's Klinger?
Klinger?
Your attention, please. Just a reminder, we are on Schedule X. Odd-numbered blocks are 15 minutes long, and even-numbered blocks are 90 minutes. Blonde-haired students should eat the first half at lunch. All others eat second half of lunch, except redheads. You can't eat at all.
I don't care about any of this stuff. My big problem is with the dress code. I've got short shorts going on. I have people wearing sweatpants. I've got holy jeans being worn that are way more holes than jeans. I just learned what the word inseam means 3 weeks ago, and I don't like it. And don't laugh, because boys, you're the biggest offenders of them all. I have seen so much underwear with sagging jeans in the last 4 weeks. It's pathetic.
Radar.
We've got tighty whities going on. We've got boxer briefs. I think I saw one of the seniors wearing My Little Pony boxers the other day.
Do we have?
We signed for that also,
all
sir.
All right.
Choppers.
Now at MASH, this is where everyone runs to the operating room for a big operating room scene, but in Mr. Klukas's hazy MASH WLA dream world, it's not an operating room, it's Mrs. Miller's biology class.
Man, what a bummer that this part is a dream. Can you imagine having real bodies in here? How cool would that be? But no, with budget cuts, I can't even get cats. Look what I get, stuffed animals. What are these new guys doing? Do you really think that is proper instruments in a biology room? I guess you can't have good looks and common sense. Although I will admit, they look safer than being in the foods room with billets. You guys are worse than the sophomores.
People. There's no jocularity going on. There's no hilarity going on. Everybody is so tense. We've got to loosen up here in order to operate We have to be able to loosen up and cooperate, have some teamwork. And the best way to have teamwork is to have some spirit here and on the football field. Spirit, the kind of spirit that a school needs for a homecoming game. Spirit, which we can do with a victory cheer. Everybody up, victory cheer, here we go.
Your 2011 homecoming princess is Paulina Pullman. Your 2011 homecoming prince is Eli Young. Your 2011 homecoming queen is Lexi Herwig. And your 2011 homecoming king is
Justice Trewin. Yeah!
And I'll
2011 Homecoming Chorus.
Yeah, you bleed just to know you're alive.